The share price collapsed. Mills, 1996. What had happened? The short explanation is that it was the technological switch from mainframe to networked microcomputers that almost led the company to fail. It was not that IBM's machinery was creaking. At its height, it was a well-oiled giant whose brand dominated the industry. Its negotiation power with suppliers was beyond reach. Scale advantages on its production lines made it impossible for others to compete on pricing, and human talent, whether high potential or senior professional, yearned to work for the Big Blue. It seems they had the necessary muscle to put every plan into practice. Could it be that IBM was so caught up in its power spheres that it felt beyond reach? Did the company not care enough about life-threatening innovation? This would be the explanation offered by the so-called Icarus paradox, Miller 1990, which describes a mechanism by which leading firms get so convinced about the superiority of their current path, they do not realise how the ground is shifting beneath their feet. Today, the finance industry is in a similar state, with a handful of big banks dominating each country's arena. Among non-banks, the picture is no different. American Express, Diners Club, Discover, JCB, MasterCard, Visa and UnionPay make up almost 82% of the entire global card volume. That's a whopping $26,044 trillion. All of these giants' balance sheets show them radiating fiscal health, so you could not really blame them if they were to get caught up in their position and ignore the potential threat of the blockchain. After all, today's model is not just working for them, but for all of their competitors.